So, welcome everyone to the today's session. Today we would be discussing about how to find the ORF of a particular gene sequence and what are the different tools that we can use if you want to find ORF, that means open reading frame of a gene sequence. The main thing that we would be covering in our today's session, that would be first, what is the significance of open reading frame? Then how a particular ORF finder, that is a tool, it searches for the ORF in a given DNA sequence using the standard genetic code or some alternative genetic codes that are specified for different organisms. How we can find all the possible ORFs that are present in a particular gene sequence and how we can use this ORF finder tool in reality. So first of all, you need to understand what is ORF. ORF, it stands for open reading frame. That means the region of a DNA sequence that starts from an initiation codon. Initiation codon is always ATG, that codes for methionine, M-E-T, I am writing it as. And that ends with a stop codon. It is called an open reading frame. That means a DNA sequence stretch that is lying between an initiation codon and a stop codon, that is known as open reading frame of a particular gene. So as you can see in this picture, this is a DNA strand onto which this is the sense strand, this is the antisense strands that you people know about it. After that, if you talk about at the messenger RNA level, this is our initiation codon that is coding for methionine, and from here to here, here it is the stop codon. So this complete stretch is known as open reading frame of a particular gene. In a similar fashion, we can find all the possible open reading frames that are present in a particular gene sequence. Because what happens is, normally proteins are made up of amino acids. And this open reading frames we can only find in those DNA sequences which are coding in nature. Because once you have analyzed the ORF, you can predict all the possible amino acids that might, you know, produce from that very DNA sequence. You can use this ORF so as to design your primers also. If you want to go for sequencing studies, in that case, you can use these ORFs so as to go for further studies. Because what happens is when the transcription happens, in that case, the DNA that is transcribed into messenger RNA inside the nucleus. In case of eukaryotes, this complete step, that means DNA to RNA and then RNA to protein, it takes place in two compartments. One is nucleus, second is cytoplasm. Because DNA is converted into RNA, that is messenger RNA, inside the nucleus, then it moves out of the cytoplasm. And in the cytoplasm, the ribosomes are assembled onto it and the protein gets transcribed. Because what happens is when each of these messenger RNA, in that case, three nucleotides, they are considered as a set, or you call it as a codon that codes for a single amino acid. And the complete amino acid sequence that you would be getting from a messenger RNA, that is known as a protein. So the initiation codon in case of translation, it is the triplet codon that will code for an amino acid, methionine always. That means the translation process will start only when there is three set of nucleotides, that is ATG, adenine, thymine, guanine. And the translation process will stop when it will encounter, or you can say when the translation machinery will encounter the stop codons. There are three main stop codons, that is TAA, TAG and TGA. In case of RNA, we call it as UAA, UAG and UGA. And any of these codons have the capability to stop the translation. So the point is, I am switching directly to the main part, that how we can find the ORF, because this transcription, translation, codons, genetic code, that you people know about it. So there are total six possible reading frames for every DNA sequence, and we normally represent those six possible reading frames by six horizontal bars. These six horizontal bars are normally observed when we go for automatic ORF finder by using some computational tool that we would be discussing in our coming slides also. So what happens is, in each direction of the DNA, there would be three possible reading frames. That means three reading frames would be in the forward direction, F I am writing it as, and three reading frames would be in the reverse direction. So those reading frames who are in the positive direction, we call them as plus one, plus two, plus three. And those reading frames who are in reverse direction, we call it as minus one, minus two, minus three. So these are the six possible reading frames that are present in any kind of DNA sequence. Now the point is how we can find these reading frames, because first of all, we need to understand how we can, suppose you have a sequence in your hand, in that case, what are the steps, how you can find these six possible reading frames. So we will be considering a hypothetical sequence. This is the sequence that I have taken. So first of all, the first thing would be, we have to divide this sequence into six different reading frames. Three in forward, three in reverse. That means plus one, plus two, plus three, minus one, minus two, minus three. And the first reading frame, if you want to obtain, in that case, because the reading frames, basically they are triplet of nucleotides. That means one codon. That means we will be considering the sequence, we will be dividing the sequence in short codons of three nucleotides. So this is the frame plus one. As you can see, herein it is started from the first nucleotide, that is CGC. After that, a space is given so as to have a clear picture. Then TAC, GTC, TTA, and that complete frame I have written. Now, second reading frame is formed after leaving the first nucleotide. That means we have to leave this, or you can say we shall not start with the first nucleotide. We shall start with this second nucleotide. In that case, it would be what it shall begin. G, C, T, then I will be leaving a space. Then it is A, C, G, and so on. So this C is left, and this is what I have written, GCT, ACG, and so on. You can construct the complete reading frame. And while you are designing for going for your third reading frame, in that case, the first two nucleotides, that means these two nucleotides have to be left out, and you shall start with this one. That means the reading frame will be like this, CTA, CGT, CTT. So I shall click on it. Now you can see this is the same thing. The two nucleotides are left and the reading frame is starting with this CTA, CGT, CTT. So from up to this point, we have designed three reading frames. You can take this sequence also. I shall post that thing in the chat box also so that you people can also do this thing along with me. So these are the three reading frames that have been designed. Now the next step is, these three reading frames, they are in forward direction right now. Now we have to design our reading frames which are in reverse direction, because in the reverse direction we are calling them as minus one, minus two, minus three. So in that case, there is a separate procedure. That means those three reading frames would be designed by first of all finding the reverse complement. So as to find the reverse complement, the first step would be to find the complement sequence. So this is the complement sequence. As you can see in the previous slide, this was the sequence. You just have to write down its complement sequence. That would be, I am writing it here with a different color. It is G, C, G, A. I have written four nucleotides. Now I'm switching to next slide so as to show whether the complement sequence is starting with this sequence or not. G, C, G, A. So you can see G, C, G, A. That means you just have to write the complement sequence of your hypothetical sequence under study. Now we have to reverse complement it. for the reverse complement, what you have to do, you have to take the sequence from here, from the last point. A, T, G. That means our reverse complement sequence shall start from this direction. That means we shall read from the opposite direction, reverse direction. So the sequence shall come A, T, G, G, C. Now see what I have written here. A, T, G, G, C. So this is a manual method. However, there are many tools available for it onto which you can simply paste your sequence and you can have the reverse complement sequence in your hand. Suppose you don't want to use the tool, in that case, you can go for this manual method also. This is a manual method and it is very easy. But this manual method won't go for longer sequences. That is why we prefer an online available tool, so as to fasten up the process. So this is the reverse complement. Now this is the final sequence that we have got for finding our next three reading frames. But we have reverse complemented this sequence. That is why we will write these reading frames as -1, -2, -3. So the same process that we have used for finding the open reading frames in the forward direction, we will be using that same methodology in case of this reverse complement sequence also. So this is the frame -1. As the sequence was starting with the ATG, so we have to start with the first nucleotide. So it is ATG and so on. Then this is the frame -2. We have to reject this first nucleotide and we shall start with this T. So we have started with this T over here. Third reading frame, in that case, we shall start with the third nucleotide. So we are starting with the third nucleotide here and the first two nucleotides are left out. So once we have got our all six possible reading frames, our next step is you have to mark the start codons and stop codons. Here I have listed all the six reading frames. Frame +1. Frame +2, frame +3, frame -1, frame -2, and frame -3. We have total six reading frames over here. Now you have to select, you have to choose where are the initiation codon, that means ATG is present, and where are the three out of the three stop codons, any of the stop codon is present. So here I have marked all the stop codons and initiation codons in all the possible reading frames. Now you see, in the first frame we shall discuss. Just a moment, I need to erase this annotation so that we can. Yes, again. So in the case of frame +1, if you if you go for manual checking of this sequence, in that case you will be observing one stop codon here, but there is no initiation codon. That means if you opt for this open reading frame, your protein won't be translated, because for the translation process to begin, the initiation codon is not there. Now you go for second reading frame. In the second reading frame, here is the initiation codon, and after a few nucleotides, there is stop codon. Then in the third frame, in that case, there is no your initiation codon or no stop codon is present. However, in the case of frame -1, there is one initiation codon starting from the first point, and then there is a stop codon over here. And then there is another stop codon, but we don't need this very stop codon, because prior to this already a stop codon is there. Then you shall go for frame -2. In that case, initiation codon and stop codons, they are present adjoining at the adjoining locations. Next is frame -3. In that case, first of all, before beginning of the translation, there is a stop codon, and here it is a start codon and this is a stop codon. So after marking all these locations, what you will be basically having the information, what sort of information that you have acquired by marking all these locations. The major point is from there you can select which of the open reading frame would be translated into a protein. If you go for checking of this, in that case, you will be seeing this frame plus one would be rejected as there is no initiation codon. Then your frame plus three is also rejected because neither an initiation codon is present nor an stop codon is present. Then this one, frame minus two, is also cancelled, also rejected because both of the initiation as well as stop codon is present at the adjoining location. So we have in our hand three reading frames, frame plus two, frame minus one, and frame minus three in hand, in which if the protein is translated by this frame, then we will be having some sort of protein product. So that means you need to identify the open reading frame sequence from the stretch that is beginning with the start codon and ending in the stop codon. So we have these three stop codons, as I told you in the previous slide, frame plus two, frame minus one, and frame minus three. You can mark the initiation codon. As you can see, I am marking the initiation codon, and you can mark the stop codon also. So this is the three selected open reading frames out of this DNA sequence. So once you have analyzed these frames, you can predict the amino acids that would be coded by these codons, so that you can predict the amino acid sequence or peptide being synthesized from a DNA sequence under study. So this is the amino acid sequence. As you can see, all of these proteins, they are starting with the amino acid methionine, and then there is a stop codon. Now this was a manual method that how you can do it, but this is a very time consuming task if you have a longer DNA sequence, because in this situation we have taken a hypothetical sequence of a certain length. So there is a online available tool, freely available tool, that is hosted by NCBI website again. And basically what this tool does, it identifies all the possible open reading frames or all the possible protein coding regions in a particular sequence. And that result is basically shown in the form of horizontal bars of a specific color. And if you click on those horizontal bars, you can have a detailed information. That means what would be the amino acid sequence, where is the start codon, stop codons, and you can even go for directly go for blast searching also if you want to find similar kind of sequences. So the complete information about that very protein or that very ORF would be shown from can be obtained from that very tool. So this is a basically hands-on session, pictures actually. So after that, we will be shifting directly to the NCBI site. So first of all, you have to open the browser and you have to type this web address. Again, this is hosted by NCBI and you will be redirected to this page. At this page, you can see there is a box. This is a box in which you can enter your query or DNA sequence of interest, for which if you want to find the ORF of that very sequence. So in that case, you can either enter the accession number, you can enter the nucleotide sequence in the FASTA format. And I think so you people are much aware of this thing, that the FASTA format, it begins with a greater than sign. This is a very important step because you have to enter the sequence in a correct format. So after that, once you have entered a nucleotide sequence in that very box, as you can see, I have entered the sequence here. After entering the sequence, you will be redirected, or you can literally scroll down, that there would be some additional dialog box. As you can see, I have marked it again, which is basically showing the genetic code. Because as I told you, the drop-down menu will be having a detailed genetic code dictionary, that it will contain around 20 different codon dictionary that will contain the codons for different organisms or organelles. You have to select that whether you want to go for standard genetic code or you want to select some alternative codon dictionaries. So after doing the selection, you can click onto the find ORF, or you can click onto the submit button and you will be redirected to a page onto which the complete ORF finder would, ORF things would be displayed in a graphical manner. There would be a complete graph as well as a complete summary that would be showing the complete information, length of the ORF, ORF number, the possible reading frame, then what would be the amino acid sequence, and if you want to go for the blast searching, you can go from there. So I am directly switching to NCBI website so that we can discuss that thing. So this is the ORF finder page. I am entering that thing in the chat box. You people, please open the site along with me. Now here you can see, you can enter the accession number. As you can see, enter the accession number, GI or nucleotide sequence in the FASTA format. If you want to go for, you know, if you do not have some sequence in your hand, in that case, you can also select some example sequence. As you can see, this is the example sequence, Salmonella enterica plasmid genetic code, starting with ATG and alternative initiation codons, minimum ORF length 300 nucleotide. Herein, this is again a nucleotide. This is a Homo sapiens BRCA gene, genetic code 1, start codon ATG only, minimum ORF length 150 nucleotide. I'm selecting this sequence. As you can see, the accession number is shown here. Now, once I have selected, I will be selecting my genetic code here. As you can see, there is a complete dictionary. We can select standard over here. It shall start with ATG only. And I am clicking on submit. So as you can see, the name of that gene, Homo sapiens BRCA2 DNA repair associated messenger RNA. And you see, they have found all the possible ORFs that are present, whether they are short stretches, because they will also analyze that where in an initiation codon is present. So as you can see, these are the ORF. This is the complete summary actually. This one, ORF 1, the strand is plus frame. That means plus frame means forward frame and forward direction. This is the frame 2, start position is 200, stop position is 10456. If I am clicking on here you can see 1CL ORF1, this is the complete sequence. Suppose I am selecting this ORF. So this ORF 11 sequence would be displayed here. And the same thing would be displayed in this graphical format also. So I am going on ORF1. So this is our ORF1 direction. And if you just scroll over this direction, see, I have just put my cursor over it and you can see the detailed information. CDS, ORF1, name CDS, location starting from 200, span on this 10,257 nucleotide sequence. Protein that would be synthesized from this very ORF would be 3,418 amino acids. The CDS position would be this, protein position would be this. And if you want to have some blast nucleotides, so these are the links to that also. Just a minute. See, blast nucleotide, blast to genome, FASTA record, GenBank record. Suppose you further want to go for blast, in that case, you can see here, there are two tabs, Smart Blast, Blast. You can select the database along up to which you want to see. So depending upon that, you can have a complete information. Whether you want to download the complete sequence, you can download this thing in a different format. As you can see, you can select the alternative sequence. The same thing would be selected in the table. You can select the ORF depending upon the from the graphical view also, as well as from this complete feature table also. This is the complete translation. I am adding the 6-frame translation track. Yeah. So see, these are the six frame translation tracks that I have added here. Let me just zoom it for you. Herein you can see the green color is showing initiation codon and red color is showing the stop codons. This is frame plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. So this is the complete thing that you can search from here. You, if you want to flip the strands, you can flip the strands. If you want to mark any position, you can do that. If you want to go for the blast and primer search, suppose you want to design the primer depending upon a particular ORF, you can select that ORF and you can click on tools. You can go to blast and primer search and then you can search. As you can see, here in three, four tabs are coming. Blast search, visible range. Blast search selection, that means the sequence that I have selected, the blast would be performed against that sequence only. Similarly, primer blast, that means complete visible range, or primer blast selection. That means that is the process that how you can use these ORFs that you have find to predict the amino acid sequence. If you want to design any primers, if you want to find any similar sequences, in that case also you can use this tool. So this is a very informative tool that is provided by NCBI. Similarly, you can select different ORFs. This is the complete ORF and it is completely showing the complete detail. This is a complete feature table, ORF 3, 9, 10, and along with that, strands are given, their frame is mentioned, start codon, stop codon, and length in nucleotides and amino acids. This is the nucleotide length, 10,257, and this is the protein that would be coded by this very nucleotide. So this is this was the complete thing about this complete ORF finder, that how you can go for ascertaining the ORFs from a particular gene sequence. I hope you people have done along this thing with me. And if you have any doubt, you people may ask, or you people also share the screen so that I can see that how you are performing.
I'm confused about that translation you showed na, six frame translation. How did
yes.
it came, ma'am? Actually, I'm not getting it.
Just a moment. See, actually, I have added the six frame translation track. I shall remove it right now, just starting from the beginning.
Okay, ma'am, got that option.
I have added that frame so that you shall have a better understanding that how these ORFs are basically shown. Because these positions, they are basically showing the location of that very ORF onto the DNA sequence. Actual six frame reading track is this, that we have just seen in the PPT also, the manual method. If you want to add this thing, you can add so as to have a better understanding actually. That these are the reading frames and up to which in this very reading frame, this is the ORF finder. Up to this location. These are basically showing the location of ORFs. As you can see in this PPT, herein also, this was the complete frame. These were the complete frames. If you talk about that, these are the frames out of which where is the ORF? The ORF is lying between this. This is the ORF that I have highlighted just now. This is the ORF. Just a moment. See, these are the six possible reading frames. In this case, if this is the reading frame, then this is the first ORF. Only one ORF is present in this very reading frame. There may be the chance that there are two ORFs in a single reading frame. As you can see, herein, this would be the open reading frame. The text. that I have highlighted. And in this case, this would be the string sequences displayed here. Because these are our ORF. We first of all have to design the frames. After that, we need to select the ORFs. There may be the thing that means that there may be the possibility that in the one frame there are two ORFs, as you can see in the previous slide. If in case in this very frame you can see in frame minus three, in that case first is the stroke codon. In that case, if in here a initiation codon was there, if it was present, in that case I would say this is an ORF1 and this is ORF2. So that depends that how many open reading frames are present in a single frame that you are using. Got my point?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
And these are only the six reading frame track, nothing else. And these are the ORFs that have been found in a single frame. As you can see, this ORF1 plus trans means forward direction. Second reading frame, in the second reading frame, it is present. There would be maybe another ORFs also, as you can see here. ORF2, this is again present in the second frame. ORF7, ORF8. So a similar manner you can basically find it. This is just to have a better understanding. I have applied this six reading.
Okay.
I think now it is clear.
Yes ma'am, absolutely clear.
Okay, Shyamali.
No ma'am, no issues. All clear.
Okay, so two people may share the screen so that I can see that the complete understanding is there.
Mama, screen is visible.
Yes, your screen is visible. So you have done this thing along with me, right? Very good.
Yes, ma'am. Salmonella.
So basically, you can simply download this feature table also, in which the complete list is there, na? You can download that complete table. You can even download the sequences. You can have a screenshot of this graphical view. You can add the six frame translation. Then you can go for BLAST. You can save the BLAST search also. So that is a complete thing that we can do from this way. It is a very interesting tool and it holds a great potential if you are working in some molecular biology field and you want to, you know, speed up your work. In that case, this ORF finder is very helpful.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, Shyamali, you may share the screen, please.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, great. You can similarly go on searching some another gene sequences also. As you can see in the example, Salmonella was also there. I think Shyamali has gone for Salmonella. That is very good. The total ORFs are 32, right?
Yes, ma'am.
And total are 32. As you can see, the six frame translation is there. You have even gone for the displaying part. Rather than adding the track, Shyamali has selected the displaying part. In that case, you can literally check it that what was the reading frame actually. Because this complete sequence, the length is very long. So in that case, if you want to display it, you can save that very information also by clicking on this six frame translation. There are two things coming, display or add the six frame translation track, or you can display the six frame translation. If you go for displaying, a separate window will appear, just like the Shyamali did. So you can save this complete information. If you want to go for the primer BLAST or BLAST searches, you can directly switch on from this very point. Right? So I'll be giving one assignment based upon this. I'll be sharing a sequence with you people. for which you first of all you need to find the ORFs, and you need to mention the complete details. How many ORFs are found? What is the complete description? As you can see that thing in the form of table in this page. You shall first of all make that table. If you want to paste few screenshots, you can paste that, like graphical display, you can add the screen translation back. You have to mention the complete screenshots of that, and you have to prepare a complete assignment and mail that. Right?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, so I think so that is done from today's side, from my side today. In case you people have any queries, thank you so much for joining today. In case you people have any query, you people can discuss that thing with me, and we can sort that thing out. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.